Hey, welcome to Grafana for Beginners. I'm Lisa Jung, and I'm a developer advocate at Grafana. In this series, we're using Grafana to visualize logs, metrics, and traces from an e-commerce app. This app has a microservices architecture, and it's running on Kubernetes. For more context about this app, go to the Microbes repo and click on the e-commerce app. It's part of an open source framework created by Dave Moore, who is a customer solutions engineer at Grafana. This is a fantastic resource for you if you want to demo, test, or learn about microservices observability. The link to the repo is in the info card up top. So logs, metrics, and traces are being collected from this e-commerce app. The logs are stored in Loki, traces are stored in Tempo, and metrics are stored in Mimir. In the last episode, we learned how to add data sources to Grafana. Today, we'll learn how to use Grafana Explore to see what's in our data. To get started, go to the homepage of Grafana Cloud or Grafana in your local environment. Click on the menu icon, then click on the Explore option. This is the Explore view. It helps you to explore the data without creating a dashboard. It also helps you to write queries that retrieve the data you want. In this episode, we'll be using Explore to verify that the data is flowing in. We'll also poke around to see what's in our data. The first step is to choose a data source you want to explore. You could do that by clicking on the Data Source option up top. You'll see a list of all the data sources you have added to Grafana. We'll start with logs. In my setup, my logs are stored in a Loki connection named Grafana Cloud Microbes Lisa Jung-logs. So I'm gonna select that. Next, we'll choose a time range for the data we want to see. I wanna look at more recent data to make sure that there's data flowing in. So click on the time range to display the drop-down menu and select the time range of last 15 minutes. The section highlighted here is the Query Builder. This is where you can write queries to retrieve the data you want. It comes with tools that guide you to build the queries, so you don't have to think about the syntax as much. One way to explore what's in your data is by looking at the labels in the data. So think of labels as fields. It consists of a key value pair that shows what information could be found in your data. When you click on the Select Label option, it gives you a drop-down menu of labels in the logs. It looks like the logs contain info regarding the cluster, the app, the container, and so on. So let's say you want to learn more about the cluster associated with the app. So you select the cluster option. When you click on the Select Value option, it'll show you all values associated with the cluster. It looks like the logs are associated with a cluster named Microbes. When you select that, you'll see that Explore has automatically built a query for you. What this is saying is to fetch me all the logs from the Microbes cluster. Now, if at any point you want an explanation about the generated query, go to the Explain Query option and click on the toggle switch, and it'll provide you with an explanation. So this is another tool at your disposal when you're getting started. Now, this in fact is the query that we want to run, so we'll click on the Run Query button. When you scroll down, Explore displays a graph of logs volume from the past 15 minutes. Scroll down a bit more, and you'll see the actual logs displayed here from the same time range. This is good news because it means that the logs are coming in as expected. When you click on the arrow, it'll show you the metadata associated with the log, like the cluster name, the application name, etc. You could also see that this log is coming from the Web Gateway container. If that is what I'm particularly interested in, I can tell Grafana to further filter by that. All you have to do is to click on the plus icon here. When you scroll up to the query section, you'll see that my query has been updated. It's saying, fetch me the logs from the Microbes cluster. From those logs, only show me the logs from the Web Gateway container. By seeing what's in your data, you can narrow down your queries to understand the data even more. Next, let's take a look at the metrics data. To do so, we'll select the correct data source up top, click to expand the drop-down menu. Our metrics data is stored in Mimir in a connection named Grafana Cloud-Microbes-LisaZhang-Prom. So we'll select that. Mimir is like an enterprise-grade of Prometheus, so it shows up as Prometheus in Grafana. Now, you'll notice that the labels we selected earlier were automatically applied here because Grafana knows how to do that within its own data sources. I want to start fresh, so highlight the query and use a backspace key to delete it. It'll return to the default page. You'll see that this page has a query builder as well. Each data source has its own query language, so the query builder is customized to that specific language. To check that the data is flowing in, we'll explore the metrics collected from the last 15 minutes. So double check that the time range is set to that. Then click on the Select Metric option here. The dropdown will list all the metrics that are coming in. By reading the names of the metrics, I sort of have a clue about what these are, but I want to know more. So I'm going to click on the Metrics Explorer. It'll list the name, type, and description of metrics that exist in our data. With more context, we could further narrow down which metrics we want to explore. If you have a rough idea of the name or the type of metric you want to explore, you can also search or filter up here instead of scrolling through every metric. All right, let's close this window. Once you choose the name of the metric, you can select the label and the value you want to filter by and run the query to get more info. Now, I want to show you another helpful tip while you're exploring your data. I find scrolling through metrics, labels, and values to be a bit tedious, and I prefer seeing more info at a glance so I could quickly figure out what I want to see more of. There are two views you could use with Explore. One is the Builder view, which is the view you're looking at right now. Then there's the Code view. So click on that. With a code view, you're able to write your query from scratch. It also offers the metrics browser. When you click on it, in one page, it displays the names of the metrics that exist in your data, plus the labels and the values associated with that metric. So it allows you to sift through the metrics a lot quicker. So let's say you come across a metric called Traces Span Metrics Latency Bucket. You're like, what's that all about? When you click on that metric, it'll automatically update the labels associated with it. Let's just click around to see what's in there. And we'll click on the label cluster. Now it'll show you that the metrics are associated with a cluster named microbes. So let's select that value. And let's narrow this down even more. So we'll look at the list of labels again. And we're looking at the metrics data from a microservices app. And I want to see what services we're working with. So let's select the label service name. Now it's showing seven services named cart, web gateway, payment, product, and checkout, which are crucial aspects of our e-commerce app. Let's say we want to look more into the payment service, so we click on that. From here, you don't even have to write a query. You've selected what you wanted to view, and it automatically generated a query for you. So this query is saying, fetch me the metrics with the name Traces Span Metrics Latency Bucket. These must be from the payment service associated with the microbes cluster. Then you're gonna click on the Use Query button, and Grafana will display the results. Up top, it displays a query that was ran. It shows you a line graph with a legend that shows you what each line represents. You can visualize the same data in different formats by selecting the format highlighted here. For example, you can select the bars option to see a bar graph, points, stacked lines, and stacked bars. So you can visualize the data in the format you need to understand what's going on within your system. And when you scroll down, you'll also see the raw data from the last 15 minutes here, which tells us, yes, we have data flowing in. And we could also see what's in the data that might be of interest to us. We could also convert this into a table view by clicking on that option if you find that view to be more helpful. So let's switch gear and take a quick look at traces. Click on the data source selector up top. The traces are stored in a Tempo connection named Grafana Cloud Microbes Lisa Zheng Traces. So we'll click on that. We'll first verify that we have new traces coming in. To do so, set the time range to the last 15 minutes and run the query. When you look at the table below, you'll see a bunch of traces that came in within the last 15 minutes. So we got data flowing in as expected. We see the trace ID, start time, service, name, and duration. And when you click on the trace ID, you could see the full traces here, which you can further delve into. Similar to the builder and code view of Loki and Mimir, there are search and TraceQL views in Tempo. Search view is like the builder view, and TraceQL is similar to the code view where you could write a query from scratch. Now we'll focus on the search view as this is more beginner friendly. The search view allows you to filter the data by the service name, span name, status, duration, and tags. So let's say you wanted to filter for traces with a duration that was greater than 1,000 milliseconds. You would go to the duration section. From the dropdown, choose a trace option and enter the value of greater than 1,000 milliseconds, then run the query. Now this will pull up all traces with a duration greater than 1,000 milliseconds. When you click on the trace ID, it'll display more details to help you understand what might be going on with your system. All right, so we just went over how you would explore logs, metrics, and traces with Grafana. Next, we'll learn how to create a dashboard with Grafana and get an overview of different types of visualization you can build with Grafana. If you want to access more episodes of Grafana for Beginners series, go to the Grafana community webpage. This is where all the community resources are shared. You can access the series by clicking on the Grafana for Beginners card. Last but not least, if you crave in-person learning and interaction with community members, you can attend a local meetup. To join a meetup group, scroll down on the page and click on the meetups card. We have meetup groups in 22 countries around the world. Search for the one closest to you to join the next meetup. And that's a wrap. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next episode.